Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Check It Out, the library talk show that lets you know what's happening in and around the Bethel Park Public Library. We're your hosts, Elaine Volpe
and Christine McIntosh, and April was a very busy month at the
library. It was, indeed.
We had a very successful book sale, and it takes a lot of work to get that book sale together, so I wanted to take a moment to say thank you to our circulation supervisor, Michelle Loria, and our Friends of the Library volunteers that come every year to help. We couldn't do it without you, and Michelle, I certainly couldn't do it without you, so thank you. We also had our Yinzers for BP Library fundraiser at the end of April,
was
a ton of fun, and I want to take a moment to, again, thank our sponsors, which are Evie True Value Hardware, Country Hammer Moonshine, Brentwood Bank, and Blue Sky Closing Services. So, busy month. But we do have some adult programs coming up. And I'm just going to tell you about a few. This is in addition to all of our book clubs and our special interest clubs and our computer classes. These are some special seminars that are going on. The first is Choosing a Business Entity, What to Consider When Starting a Business. This will be held on Wednesday, May 9th at 7 p.m. and is presented by Tracy Ziemer, who is an attorney. So the seminar will provide an overview of the various legal entities for your business, sole proprietor, partnership, limited liability company, or corporation. You'll learn the pros and cons of each type of business entity with a focus on how to form one of those companies. She will discuss the risks associated with each type of entity and give you an overview of tax issues. We have Healthy BP for All on Wednesday, May 16th at 7 p.m. This is brought to you by the American Heart Association and the American Stroke Association. So if you or someone you love has high blood pressure, you can come and learn how to check, change, and control your blood pressure in this free four-week evidence-based management program. Signing up for the program entitles you to monthly health lessons at the library to gain skills related to blood pressure management, an online health mentor that will be there to answer questions for you, resources to self-monitor and check your blood pressure. There'll be some free giveaways. Plus, the first 10 participants who register will also receive a six-week free cooking class so you can learn how to cook nutritious and delicious meals that fall in line with your blood pressure management program.
And those will be offered in the summer, the cooking classes, correct?
The cooking classes will be offered, yes.
And who is that through? Who is this on?
Is the American Heart Association, American Stroke Association, I believe through the University of Pittsburgh, but okay. I will not swear to that. We would have to ask Carla on that.
Sure. That's a great program.
It is a great program. We have a seminar on preparing your home to sell in Bethel Park. This will be Saturday, May 19th at 11 o'clock. You'll learn how to get the most money for your house from Bethel Park's leading experts. So we have Shane Kunkel, who is a realtor, Tom Scheidler, who is a home inspector, David Barone from Barone & Sons Appraisal, and also Betsy, Ballner, and Jeanette Shanahan from Porchlight Home Stagwig. So you can come and figure out how to... I know there's not a lot of inventory right now in Bethel, so they're looking for houses. So if you're thinking about selling, now might be the time. We have Dr. Christopher Carr of Pittsburgh Chiropractic and Wellness with a weight loss challenge. This will be hosted on Tuesday, May 22nd at 7 p.m. So even though your first motivation for dropping some pounds may be to look better, of course, losing weight is really more important than that. The fact is that being overweight is commonly linked to a host of avoidable illnesses such as diabetes, heart disease, cancer, stroke. So he'll provide you with a plan backed by cutting-edge science on how to turn your body into a fat-burning machine so you lose weight and keep it off for good. This is kind of like the paleo diet, so it's more
like... Can you remind me what the paleo is
like
again?
Like whole foods, things that you would have eaten as an ancient human being. So
no processed foods.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's
so when
be
is
good.
This? I need to write this
Tuesday,
down.
May 22nd at 7 p.m. We have an introduction to Reiki on Wednesday, May 30th at 7 p.m. This is presented by Wendy Bourne, who is a Reiki master and teacher. If you know you aren't feeling your best, but you don't know how to get there, it's time to work on your energy system. An introduction to Reiki explains what Reiki is, how it works, how it affects your energy system to create balance and well-being in all aspects of your life, including your mind, your body, and your soul. And kind of in the same vein, introduction to transcendental meditation.
Uh-huh.
I would like to try this.
What kind of meditation?
Transcendental. TM, okay. Did you ever hear it?
Mm-mm.
That was like hippie time.
Yeah, no, I've heard of it. I've heard of it. I just didn't know exactly. I've never meditated, honestly. I wouldn't mind trying it myself.
I have tried. Part of my problem has always been I can't keep things out of my head.
Right.
So when you're trying to meditate, like something pops in. This transcendental meditation doesn't require you to empty your mind.
Oh, okay.
I just saw a thing on Dr. Oz about this. Last week.
Interesting.
Yeah. So this will be Thursday, May 31st at 7, presented by Marty Kaplan, the director of the Western PATM program. So transcendental meditation is a simple, natural, effortless mental technique practiced for 15 to 20 minutes a day while sitting comfortably in a chair with your eyes closed. Extensive research shows that regular practice of TM provides profoundly deep rest, which lets the body and mind heal and refresh from within. TM eliminates accumulated deep stress and fatigue, allows for clearer thinking, greater energy and creativity. It wakes up the brain and allows the whole body and mind to enjoy balanced health and freshness of life. So.
That sounds great. I imagine it would help with anxiety too, don't you think?
Yes, we are an overly anxious society now.
We are.
So those are just a couple things that are going on for adults, and also I have what's coming out on DVD for you in
Ooh.
May. Stay tuned.
The most important thing a man can take into combat is a reason why.
You're in this fight, boys. You mark my words.
19 men attacked our country. The 12 of you will be the first ones to fight back.
It's us. We're going in.
Why? These men follow you.
You take me to the Taliban, I'll show you.
Okay.
We take horses.
50,000 Al-Qaeda fighters.
And yours just an army of 12.
We've just been handed the most important mission in the free world.
Hold on. Our boys are gonna ride into battle on horseback?
The chances are we are not gonna make it out of this one. If we quit now, what happened back home is gonna happen again and again.
Get out.
Each of you gotta make this decision.
Fall back!
Nothing I'd rather do.
I'm in.
Thought you'd never ask.
Where the hell do those come from?
Take out biggest guns first.
I am your biggest gun, Cap.
The only way home is winning.
Do you believe in ghosts, Dr. Price?
I do not believe in anything I cannot see or study.
I feel their presence. In the air, in the walls, it has found us.
Mrs. Winchester, why all that construction?
The spirits killed by the rifle. We lock them away. 13 nails seals them in. I will do whatever it takes to protect my family. This spirit has a power we've not seen before. Your anger will never defeat us.
Good morning, wife.
Good morning, husband.
We're being followed.
But some of us don't know why.
Anna.
Jack, what do you want?
So you want to play?
Yes, sir.
I made a vow to love you faithfully, forsaking all others.
Did you sleep with her?
To comfort you in times of need, and to keep you safe for as long as we both shall live.
There are whispers of a Hebrew with great strength. It is a story for slaves, nothing more.
I want you to investigate this.
No,
you find me the secret of his power.
My Delilah.
Well, if you wanted to fight, you should have brought more men.
I want him dead.
The strength of a god. I saw it with my own eyes.
He is not a god!
Samson, the Philistines are upon you.
My strength is now your strength.
No!
What would you have me do?
My name is Samson, and you will face the wrath of God.
So come on in and check out one of those DVDs, or remember, we have thousands of DVDs, the classics up through the current releases. So come on in. What's going on over your way?
So we too had a very busy April and some bigger events coming up in May, but our weekly story times have stopped for May, and so we're kind of slowing down as far as offerings on a regular daily basis. But one of the things that we have in May, early in May, it's our art gala, so
yes,
we're very excited about that. So it's not too late to submit your artwork. Our art gala is planned for Friday, May 11th at 6 p.m. And you know how it works is if you have a piece that you would like to show off, we ask you to donate it to the art gala. When you drop off your piece, we'll give you a special tag, and on that tag, you can say whether or not you want it to go for sale or if you want the item back. If you do choose to have it go for sale, then the proceeds come to the library. So it kind of acts as a fundraiser for us. But if you want that piece back, we certainly make sure that we return it back to you. So it's just a great way to display your work, and you can certainly have it back if you want. Everybody from the community is invited. It's $5 if you buy your ticket in advance, $10 at the door. But anybody who submits artwork will get their artist ticket for free. So pieces are slowly coming in, and we've got some really neat, some beautiful sculptures that have really impressed me.
I love sculpture.
So remember, art can be just about anything. You know, photography, sculpting, painting, sketches. What else? Somebody sewed some things last time. You're doing
fiber arts,
yes. And you're doing something with yarn, I believe.
String. And I don't know if it's going to be finished in time, I'll be honest.
Get on it. It's okay.
It's
okay. Like I said, I think we have enough because these pieces are slowly rolling in. But if you still want to enter, you can do so up until May 8th because we have to have time to mount it and get it ready. Again, the art gala is scheduled for May 11th. So don't miss out. We would love to see you there. Now, back in February, we hosted a writer's workshop, and we had about 12 kids who came consistently, and they all had wonderful story ideas. They were then all submitted to the WQED Writers Contest, and I'm so proud and so happy to say that one of those students that were in the workshop has placed in the contest.
So exciting.
So congratulations to you, Harris. Harris is in first grade. I believe he goes to Memorial Elementary School. He will be invited down to the WQED studios next week, where he will get to record his studio, record his story for radio down there. It'll be broadcast on the Saturday morning Light Brigade. Have you ever heard of that?
Oh, yes, I have.
It's awesome. And then his story will also be uploaded to the WQED website. I wanted to share it today on today's show because I'm so excited about it, but then I'm going to encourage all of you viewers out there to go onto the WQED website starting May 11th, and if you visit that site between May 11th and May 18th, you can vote for Harris's story, because on top of the award that he has already won, he is eligible for the Reader's Choice Award. So there's another award on top. that has a scholarship attached. So wouldn't it be wonderful if he won that as
well? So we have to vote?
Yeah, Reader's Choice is based on how many online votes each story gets.
Wonderful.
So I'm going to share it with you on today's show, and then I encourage you to go to the WQE website May 11th through 18th and vote for it. And then when you go to the site, you actually get to hear Harris narrating his own story too, which is much better than what I will do today. But I'm going to try to do it justice. It is called The Fish Who Had a Wish by Harry Wanous. My name is Finney. I want to tell you something horrible that happened once in my life and how I solved it. It started when I was born. But like, there's so much detail in these illustrations. It's called the Fishatory Museum, right? When I was a baby, I thought that oceans were supposed to be dirty and it was supposed to rain trash, but I didn't think that was right. And when I was about 2, I saw a huge creature dropping a trash can into the water, and I learned that it was dirty because people were littering. My friends at school thought the trash was a free treat, and they were getting really sick. Right, from eating all the litter that's being dumped into the ocean.
I love the nurse fish.
Uh-huh. It's awesome.
She's awesome.
So, I thought of a plan. First, I found a scuba diver. Next, I tried to be funny so he would follow me. Then I had to find the spot with the most trash. After that, I wrote, "Help us," in the sand with my fin. Finally, the scuba diver cleaned up some of the trash. Then he went back up to land and told his friends about the trash, and his friends told their friends, and everyone started to help clean up the oceans. Finally, my friends felt better, and the oceans were clean again. The end.
That's very clever.
So he won't find out until he goes to the celebration in Oakland on May 19th. He won't find out if he placed first, second, third, or if he placed in the STEM category. I could see this winning in both kind of placing and being STEM. Because what a wonderful message about recycling and taking care of the earth. Again, Amazing. Shout out to Harris Wanous. Great job, my man. Don't forget to vote for our friend. Now joining us is the Children's Department's newest member, Miss Nancy Martin, who's not really new anymore, but I feel like we didn't do this a couple months ago, so we're doing it now. So happy to have you on board.
So happy to be here.
You've done a great job, and I know I tell you that all the time, but it really is true. I feel like no matter what task I give you, you do it. You've kind of been all over the place. I have you doing a lot. One of the things that you've been doing, and I know we only have one more to go, it's coming up in May, is our Crafty Saturdays.
Right.
Why don't you show our viewers what we're doing in May, because I love this cute idea.
So Saturday, May the 12th, I think it is, we are going to be making Mother's Day cards, and we're going to make these little flowers that go in this little pocket, and then one of the flowers is going to be a felt and popsicle stick bookmark.
Love that idea.
For the moms, and then inside you can decorate it however they want, and happy Mother's Day.
Yeah, but I love the little pocket idea on the front there. And so the other flowers are not on popsicle sticks. What did we use there?
They are just on folded pieces of green paper.
Oh, they look fit. Okay, I thought it was
foam or
something.
No, it's just folded. No, and then they're going to cut out their own circles because it's going to be their own creation. So,
love it. So yeah. Crafty Saturdays is open to kids of all ages, well, all elementary kids, K through 4. And there's no registration, so you can just stop by, as Miss Nancy said, on May 12th, which is a Saturday.
Great.
Right? Mm-hmm. And then the other program that I wanted to kind of talk to you a little bit about, even though it's not for a while, I thought we could give our viewers a sneak peek of Passport Pals.
Right.
Which is, go ahead and explain a little bit about it. And
well, so it's a program that Miss Elaine learned about from the Robinson Township Library. We should probably give them credit for
that. A shout out, yes. Yeah. We love to share ideas. So thank you to Robinson Township.
Yes, and it's basically going to be a 6 weeks long, once a week, and we're going to visit a different country in each class. And I ran them by you, so we're going to visit Canada. I picked South Korea because of the Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
We picked Cuba because of so many changes going on there. Uganda, because we have a local family who has
awesome.
A connection to Uganda.
Yes.
So they are going to come help us participate in that. And then India and Russia, I think, are the last two. And they're going to be little passports we make, and the kids get a stamp for each country. And there'll be a quick presentation where they can learn about life in the country and the country itself. But there's also going to be, for each country, a relevant craft, snack, and game. Yes, and music.
It's a very well-rounded program. A little taste of everything, which I love. And I know you're very well-traveled. Out of all the countries that she's named, how many have you been to?
To the ones that Canada.
I've only been to one. Canada.
Yeah, me too.
I've not been to Cuba.
Didn't you want to go to Cuba? What's Cuba's
that on
your
list? Cuba's on my short list.
See, Canadians go to Cuba all the time.
Yeah.
Because there's not. There was never a restriction.
Yeah.
That's on my short list. So.
Now, interestingly enough, you are from Canada, so
I
we're going to start with Canada as the first country on that passport, just because
right.
I think you feel the most
comfortable
with that.
Talking about it. Yes.
So, go ahead and give us some Canada fun facts, because I've been there only twice, both to Niagara Falls. I haven't been to any other part of Canada, although I hear Toronto is beautiful.
Been to Toronto.
Someday I'd
it
like
is.
To get there, but I
it
don't
is.
Know too much about the country, other than it is the second largest in the world
in terms of
correct?
Land size. Yes.
Yes,
not by population, but by land size behind Russia. Okay. Yes, this is true.
It has many, many lakes.
Okay.
Does
yeah.
it?
Yeah, no, it does.
Okay.
I mean, we border the Great Lakes
and
just like you
And you serve poutine.
We do serve poutine.
This is about all that I know, and that's because a few years back, I did a book trailer on this book called The Biggest Poutine in the World. Now, some people, when I tell them what it is,
go, ew.
Turn their nose on it. But I think I would love it.
Oh, it sounds fantastic.
So,
it
here's
is
my question
heavenly.
For you.
Okay.
It has like French fries with cheese curds.
It's French fries with cheese curds and hot gravy poured over, which makes the cheese curds kind of melt.
Like,
and the gravy and the cheese together
me.
Sounds a bit strange, but it is the most delicious thing.
Okay, are there different versions? Or is it just?
I'm sure there are.
Poutine is
yeah,
curds
like that's
gravy.
That's the traditional, and I'm, okay. people do all kinds of strange.
I think
like now there's like tandoori poutine, and you can do anything, but that's the traditional.
I think because of the word cheese curd, that curd sounds.
Yeah, maybe that's what turns
sounds
people
like
off.
Sour milk. But
perhaps.
It's fantastic.
I'm glad you agree.
Yes.
Where did
you've
you
actually
it?
Had it?
In Canada.
Where
oh.
in Canada?
But I didn't know in Kitchener. I went to visit some relatives
okay.
of the guy that I had been dating, and they were Croatian. So in addition to getting all the great Croatian food, they did take me out for poutine, which
you have to have poutine.
So
in
is it like a staple? Like where would you get poutine?
It is not really a staple. No, it's not. It's
or?
Not like that. It's just kind of a, yeah. It's not. Now what is a staple is Tim Hortons.
We went to
and you
Hortons.
Do have some now. Like there's Erie has them, I know. New York State has some, but that is the place. I mean, you want to see the longest drive-through line of cars you've ever seen. In
I've
fact,
never heard
people
of
have
Tim
done
Hortons.
PhD like thesis, PhD theses on wait times and the psychology of the people who will, how long
no
the
way.
Line will be before they'll. Yeah, oh yeah.
Don't you ever see Tim Hortons on the boards on a hockey game?
Always.
Huh.
And
oh,
the big
man.
Thing for my children, it's hockey. The Timbits, which are like the donut holes, but they're called Timbits.
I was saying, so what does Tim Hortons serve?
Donuts.
Coffee.
Yeah,
oh,
coffee. Their coffee
place.
Is like,
okay.
I don't know what it is about their coffee, but there's no other coffee that tastes quite the same. So there's coffee, donuts, bagels. They've expanded, like breakfast sandwiches, you know, nice lunch soups and that kind of thing. But we go for the donuts.
So you visit Canada often because you still
yes,
have family in
we
Canada.
Do, right? Yes.
So do you make sure you hit a Tim Hortons every time?
Always.
Yeah.
Always.
In fact, I kind of feel like a road trip coming on. I want to go check out a
no,
Tim
it's
Hortons.
True. I mean, we've all four kids and everyone has aww. Their specific order. And
yeah.
Like sometimes they'll have, it's cute, sometimes they'll do like, there's one called the, what is it called? The Canadian Maple. And like that's William's favorite. And then it's like a stuffed cream donut with maple glaze on top.
And bacon.
And maple's a big thing back
bacon.
Home.
It needs bacon.
They,
yeah.
Yes, they've got that too.
My son would love that. Great. So give us a couple other, if you wouldn't mind, give us like five fun facts about Canada.
Okay.
Or for your five favorite things.
Well, things
Canada.
I love. So one thing is that we're a bilingual country. So we have two official languages instead of just one. So we have English and we have French. And so if you buy, you know, a box of cereal, it's not just, everything has to be in both languages. So, you know, we grew up looking at both languages in the back
yeah,
of the
so
cereal
are you fluent
box.
In French?
I'm fairly fluent. I'm functionally fluent.
So you could teach French.
I spent a
I
year.
I have another program
there
idea
you
for you
go.
In the fall.
Why'd
but I spent a year living in Quebec between,
well,
like.
We've offered Spanish, but we've never offered French.
I would love to do that. That would be
that
awesome.
That is awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, so
okay,
two.
So that would be one. The second that's really interesting is, I can't remember exactly what percentage it is, but I'm going to say like 80% of Canadians live within 100 kilometers of the U.S. border. Like, if you look at a population density map, I mean, we hug that border because the further north you go, the less habitable the country becomes.
Mm-hmm. Cold.
Because of weather, right? Cold temperatures? Or?
Yeah, and just, yeah, yeah, I think that's.
That's where Sasquatch lives.
You know, it's funny. Someone else made, I grew up in Canada. I don't know this, like, Sasquatch thing that has somehow become associated with Canada.
Yeah.
Really?
Saskatchewan.
There, but
is that like a thing? But the Saskatchewan's a prairie. It's completely flat. So what's the Sasquatch doing there?
I don't know.
Nobody knows yet.
Oh.
speaking of sets, so did Rob tell you about his idea?
Yes.
So we're having a Bigfoot program in the fall.
It'll be well attended.
Are we?
Yes, we are.
Who's running that?
Rob.
Well, he
found somebody who's actually...
There's a society.
So it'd be an
Bigfoot society.
I had no idea.
Very cool.
Maybe
a lot of Bigfoot going on because Lemons, one of our CCA titles,
was such a good
has
book.
Bigfoot, which I loved. Yeah, has Bigfoot in it. So like just recently, in the past couple months, like all I'm hearing about is Bigfoot. But it's great. It's a fun topic.
Yes. Okay. So that was two.
So three.
Third is Smarties. So down here, you guys at Halloween especially have those little rolled candies, and you call those Smarties.
I never really liked.
No, me neither.
So sweet. Like
in Canada, they're called Rockets, and Smarties, which I will have at our program. Are like M&Ms.
Hmm.
Oh. So they're candy-coated chocolate.
Ooh.
And that's what a Smartie is in Canada.
Can you save me one?
Yes, I will save you some for sure.
All right. Number four.
You've really put me on the spot here. I guess I just love the diversity of like the landscape. So once I drove from British Columbia back to Ontario, and like you drive through the Rockies, the mountains, and then you, as you enter Alberta, you watch those mountains like disappear, and then in front of you, you can see for miles. Like a dog comes across the road, like 3 miles down the road, you can see it.
Huh.
And then you know you keep going, and it gets more forested, and then you get to the coast, and it's so the East Coast
it's
is
beautiful.
So beautiful. Yeah. So I like that. And another cool fact is that since I was born, when I grew up, we had 10 provinces and 2 territories, and now we have 10 provinces and 3 territories, and they added one, not more land, they just took part of the land and created the territory of Nunavut, and it is governed by the native peoples of Nunavut.
Yeah. And in Canada, they call what we would say Native American is first...
First peoples, first people. Nations, we also say Native Canadians, but first nations, first peoples, that's true. Was that 5?
It was indeed. Oh, is it true that you, Canada is the most, well-educated country in the world?
It's
over half of
be
your residents get a college education.
I can't answer that.
Yeah.
But I mean,
I googled that before I came down.
So you looked very, impressive. Yes,
I didn't know that. I was like, oh, that's another.
But something that is interesting now that I'm visiting colleges is, you know, I could probably name every single college in Canada. Like, I don't know how many there are, but let's say there are 50 to 70. I mean, there are that many in the Pittsburgh area. Like, it's so different in terms of the number of university. We call them universities.
I'm just curious. Is tuition more affordable in Canada than it is in
Far more affordable, yes. Not free. It's
Isn't
not free. But it is definitely more affordable.
As is your health care.
Why is it so expensive here in the
U.S.? Yes, our health care is free.
Oh, that's right. You mentioned that once before, too.
You might have to. Sometimes you have to wait a little longer, but you never have to worry about whether or not you can afford to pay for it.
Wow.
Wonderful.
That's great. Lots of interesting facts. So, if you're in elementary school, what did we say? K-4?
No, second through fourth.
This is for grades 2, 3, or 4. Don't miss out on this fabulous Passport Pals program starting again this summer. I think the dates are, we're going for 6 weeks to get those stamps on your passport. Starts in July, I believe.
I think you're right.
And then we'll spill into August. So, be sure to stay tuned for that.
I learned a lot, so I'm sure everybody will learn a ton.
Absolutely. So thank you so much for joining us, Nancy. It's
thank you for
pleasure.
Having
me. If you
have
not yet met Nancy, please stop in the Children's Department to say hello. Thanks again.
Thank you.
So thanks to Nancy again. What a treat to have her on the show. She really does have a lot to share.
She has fit into our staff very nicely, too.
She really has. So make sure, again, to check out Passport Pals, and she'll have other programs coming up as well.
I just have a few announcements. The library will be closed on Sunday, May 27th. And Monday, May 28th for the Memorial Day holiday. And then the library will be closed Sundays throughout the summer until Labor Day. So if you want to come by on a Sunday, we're not going to be here after Memorial Day. So,
well, as always, if you have any questions, comments, or concerns about anything that we talked about on today's show, you know what to do. Go ahead and give us a call.
Visit our website.
Or better yet, stop in and see us in person. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next month.